How y'all doing, family? This is Chris Rob with Media TV, and I'm going to be coming to you with this news. Getting this news from www.afro.com, and says the title is Baltimore's Pastor Brown Talks Being Trolled by Russian Operatives. This was published by Sean Yeo's Baltimore Afro editor. This came out on February 21st, 2018. So, family, we're about to get into this story. It says Pastor Herbert Brown, third of the Pleasant Hope Baptist Church in Northeast Baltimore, an activist leader in the community, recently revealed a Facebook confrontation in the midst of the uprising of 2015 was more than a simple beef with an internet troll. Yeah, family, y'all gotta watch out for these damn internet trolls, because you already know how these fucking racist-ass white people get mad when we fucking come out with the truth and tell it what it is and speak from within the heart of how we feel, what's going on. Sorry, family. What's going on in the world and stuff like that. So, let's get back into it. It says, during the turbulent days following the uprising in the aftermath of the death of Freddie Gray in April 2015, Brown engaged in a Facebook encounter with what turned out to be a Russian operative, cited in Robert Mueller's investigation into Russian meddling in the 2016 election. The operative was allegedly charged with sowing discord within Baltimore's black community, specifically to suppress the black vote, which they always do. They always want to suppress the black vote in everything, and especially with them in voter booths, because they don't want us to express how we feel, and they don't want us to vote these racist-ass caucasoids out these motherfucking official offices and stuff like that. So they always going to try to say, oh, you need a ID, oh, you need this, oh, you need that, just to run us away from the voting booth and stuff like that. So, get back into it. It says, Brown relived the incident last night during an interview with MSNBC's Ari Melber, host of The Beat with Ari Melber. Some short time after the uprising of 2015, there was a lot of energy in the air around social change and challenging the system of society to make it more just, particularly to African Americans here in this city, Brown told Melbourne. Yeah, because we're always, the system has never done a damn thing for us. The system was set up for these fucking white ass cave monkeys, cave devils. Anything they fucking do in a system, oh, he got mental illness. Oh, he didn't know. Oh, he was too rich to understand. Nah, we don't want to fucking hear that shit. If we have some fucking weed, a little fucking nickel bag of fucking weed, we get, what, 5 years, 10 years, just for a small bag of fucking weed and shit like that. You feel what I'm saying? Anything we do, we always get punished 10 times more than white people, because the system is set up for these fucking cave devils. But, oh, times is changing, and now they getting hit with the book now. And I'm glad it's going down right now. So, that's something good to hear. But, let's see. Let's get back into the story, family. So, there was a number of people who were coming to Baltimore's to help support local organizers. But there also were people who were coming to the city to make Baltimore their platform and stage to make a name for themselves. Brown said he was able to discern the individual was not a part of the city's activist community and was able to alert others in the grassroots community and ultimately thwart the efforts of the Russian operative. Yeah, so you had people that wasn't even in the activist group and that wasn't even in, that didn't even live in Baltimore, and within the city, and they were coming to kind of like bring their narrative to the activist movement and to the black community And when Brown saw it, he said, "Oh no, 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 they ain't about to go down like that." So then it says, did you ever think at the time that it could be part of an international criminal conspiracy, which included trying to suppress the black vote?" Melber asked Brown during the interview. "Nowhere in my wildest dreams did I ever think that any of that would be involved with my engagement and confrontation of this person on Facebook and on Twitter. Blew my mind when I found out that," said Brown, who is also a co-founder of Baltimore United for Change. In this one example, we see how social inequality is not just for a factor that can negatively impact African American communities, but also become an issue of national security. It's just really a great example of how we really have to redouble our efforts to have a more just and equitable society so that the conditions are not created for people to take advantage of in the first place. Of course, we're always getting taken advantage of. Always. But it just shows you that these Russian motherfuckers could come here, do all this kind of fucking shit, and Trump ain't saying a motherfucking word. But oh, Trump fucking worrying about, he's so busy worrying about NFL players kneeling for the anthem, when this dumb motherfucker had his Russian people come over here, and especially Vladimir Putin, his white daddy that he's scared of, and he won't say a damn thing about it. "Oh no, he didn't do nothing and stuff like that, and I believe him." Yeah, motherfucker, we already know y'all with each other and shit like that, so it's just crazy how it's keep going down and it's keep happening and they're getting exposed. So like I said, family, just want to come to y'all with the news and everything, and y'all have a good night.